Hello and welcome to video 5 of module 4, graphing the least squares regression line. In this video, we'll explore one way that you can use to graph a least squares regression line. The method we're going to use is by identifying two points on the line, graphing them, and then connecting them. So let's get started. Just a reminder that throughout the module 4 videos, we're looking at a dataset that Harriet collected of displacement volume and combined city and highway mileage for several 2017 vehicles. We'll be using this data and the least squares regression line that Harriet found to complete the next examples. Remember that Harriet determined the least squares regression line to be y hat equals 34.103 minus 2.804x. So this is the equation that we're going to be graphing in a moment. In order to graph the least squares regression line, our big strategy is to find two points on the line and connect them. However, this can be a little bit tricky because you have a lot of freedom in the points that you choose. So I'm going to give you some guidance and some recommendations that I usually follow when graphing a line, but this is not like always do this and always do that. It's more of a let's think about this and do something that makes sense. So the first thing that I like to do when I'm graphing a line on a scatter plot is to choose a value for x on the left-hand side of the scatter plot. You usually want to pick a number that's close to your points, but not at the exact same place as your points, because if you have to graph a point on top of a point, it can be hard to tell where the point you drew is. So we'll look at that in practice. And then once you pick that value for x, you plug it into your least squares regression line equation, and that will give you a y value for the point. And then you're going to repeat that process, except now you're going to pick an x value on the right-hand side of the screen instead of on the left-hand side. Substitute that into the formula and solve for y. Once you have those two points, you can graph them and you connect them with a line. The goal is going to be that your line should fill up the whole space. So no teeny tiny, as small as possible lines here. Take out your ruler and connect those points with a line. So we want the lines to fill the graphing space. And then for a final touch, you're going to add an arrow to either the left or the right as is appropriate for the data that you have. That again is going to depend on what your data looks like. If it makes sense for your line to continue for a long time to the right or to the left, then you're going to have arrows. But if it doesn't make sense, then you're not going to include them. So let's look at an example. Okay, so I've got Harriet's equation of the least squares regression line on the top of the screen and a scatter plot for her data here as well on the left. Before I begin doing anything, I want to make sure I'm familiar with this graph. So if I look on the vertical axis, it goes from 15 to 35. It's marked out by 5 miles per gallon. And each of those lines looks like it represents 1 mile per gallon. So if I were to count the lines, I'd start at 15, and then there's a line for 16, 17, 18, 19, and then 20 is the next one marked. On the horizontal axis for displacement volume in liters, I'm going to familiarize myself with that axis as well. So it looks like they've counted out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and each of those units is broken up into 5 spaces. So 1/5 is the same as 0.2. So if I count the lines on the horizontal axis, I'm starting at 0, and then I have 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1. 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8, 2, etc. So when I want to begin by graphing a point, I want to find an x value kind of on the left-hand side of the graph. The easiest number to use would be 1, but I notice that there's a point 1.31. So there's already a point there, which may make it harder for me to graph. So I'm going to decide to look at 0.4. I'm going to choose an x value of 0.4. You could choose to use 1 if you want, although I wouldn't recommend it. Maybe 1.2 would be a good value, or 0.8, just something kind of on the left-hand side. I'm going to take that x value and substitute it into my least squares regression line equation. and use that to determine a y-hat value. So in this case, when I did that, I got 32.9814, which I rounded to the nearest tenth to get 33.0. I figured rounding to the nearest tenth would give me something still decently accurate, but easy to graph. So that's my plan, find something that's going to be a little bit easy to graph. So in this case, I've already got my 0.4 indicated. 33 is right on up here. And so where those two lines intersect is where I'm going to plot my first point. Next, we're going to repeat this process for an x value on the right-hand side of the graph. So that rightmost dot appears to be like, what, 5.7 or so? So I'm going to pick a nice, easier number towards the right of the graph. I'm going to pick to use 5 because there's no dot in that vicinity and it's on the right-hand side. So I'm going to substitute 5 into my formula, do some computations, and I got 20.083. So again, I rounded that answer to the nearest tenth. I got 20.1. Again, because that's going to be easier for me to graph. 20.1 is going to be just above the 20 line. So I decided to put the arrow on the right-hand side here since that's where I'm looking. So I'm just above the 20 line, and that's where I'm going to plot my point. So now I have two points that are on the line. So to graph the line, I'm going to connect them. Now, if you wanted to find some nicer points to graph, if you got some really nasty decimals that are really hard to graph on your grid, or you wanted a third point just to make sure that you didn't make a mistake in your computation, you can do that. So I might have chosen another point like maybe 2.6 or so, closer to the middle, or maybe 4 or 4.4, something like that, where there's not a lot of points nearby, to get another point to graph for my line. Then to finish the line, I have to decide whether or not it makes sense for these values to continue in either direction. In a previous video, we determined that the y-intercept did not make sense to interpret for this data. What that means is on the left-hand side, I'm not going to put an arrow because it doesn't make sense to have negative displacement volume values. But I could continue on the right-hand side, especially because my vertical axis doesn't start until 15. So this line may continue more to the right. So I'm going to put an arrow on the right-hand side of my line, but I'm not going to put one on the left-hand side. Also notice that my line fills my entire graphing space. So no teeny tiny little line between two super close points, but it fills the whole space. This is so that if I needed to use this line to make predictions or comparisons, I can do so because it's here for the whole screen. Also notice that the line falls among the points, right? This seems to be a good estimate, a good indicator for what these points are doing. Another way you can check your line to make sure it's correct is by looking at other predictions you've made. For example, in the second video for Module 4, we made a prediction for a Camry and for the Chrysler 300. The Camry, we predicted that based on a displacement volume of 2.5 liters, the vehicle would have approximately a mileage of 27 miles per gallon. For the Chrysler, we predicted the other way, but it's still a prediction. We predicted that if the mileage was 23 miles per gallon, then the volume would be about 4 liters. If I look at the line that I drew, both of these predictions were made using that equation. So both of these predictions should be on the line. So the Camry is this point here, this little purple dot, and that has an x value of 2.5 and a y value of about 27. So that prediction is on the line. That means we graphed our line properly. Let's see if the Chrysler is there as well. So the Chrysler 300 had an x value of 4 and a y value of 23. Check it out. There it is on our line as well. So another way that we could have graphed this line was going back at our work and saying, did we make any predictions earlier? And if we did, we could have just used those points to draw that line. What's nice about picking a point on the left of the screen and a point on the right of the screen, however, is that you get a line that's going to fill the whole space. The closer together the points are that you choose to plot, the more subtle off you could be with your graph. All right, that concludes our video on graphing the least squares regression line. In the next video, ooh, it's dangerous. We're going to talk about some ways that you could use the least squares regression line improperly. And so really, we want to focus on how do you use it properly. So thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.